most important expectations from the all the corporate sectors. Like, you know, yes, the person who is coming on board is loud enough that, you know, yes, we should be able to catch that person. Understood?
Yes, sir.
All right. So let's, like, you know, loads of things have been already talked about me, so I need not, like, you know, touch upon those areas. About e-value serve has also been talked about it, but, like, you know, just I would like to share one or two slides with you about e-value serve. This is what. So we started in year 2000. Now you can see the journey, like, you know, on the top from the left. Like, we started in 2000, and as of now we are more than 2700 people. This organization is purely into research and analytics. Okay? Do you understand research and analytics? Who understands research and analytics? Tell me, raise your hand. Okay, who understands research? Research kya hota hai? Okay, and?
So do you deep study in a particular topic or like field?
Okay, good. Anybody else? Let's say if I pick up somebody to answer this. Should I pick up somebody to answer this? You answer. Yes, please.
We need to study or discover something.
Okay. So everybody sitting in this room, do you agree with all the answers, like, you know, which have been given by your batchmates? Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then tell me, what is analytics then? What is analytics? What do you understand by analysis?
Sir, we compare two things or two objectives.
Okay. Anybody else?
Analysis is extracting information out of data which we have recovered after researching on some topic. After putting our insight in some topic of study.
Okay. Nice answer. Alright, so now I tell you, when we talk about research and analytics, now you might have heard about, like, you know, any product, let's say for example Glaxo. Glaxo is an organization and they want to introduce one medicine in India market or maybe in China market, right? So what eValueServe does, these clients will actually, I'm just taking one example, so they will come back to us saying that, you know, this is the kind of medicine for this kind of ailment. We want to introduce it in China. Regulations are concerned. Are they really complying to the compliance of that particular country? Okay. Now, eValueServe, what it does, the research team of eValueServe for this kind of, you know, client who is into pharma, healthcare. Now, these are the doctors. These can be the B pharmas, like, you know, who understands the drugs, who understands the chemical composition of the drugs. So what they will do, they will actually, you know, do the research and analysis on that particular kind of drug, whether, like, you know, whether that particular kind of drug is available in the China market or not. If it is available, then what is the chemical composition? If Glaxo is coming up with this kind of chemical composition, whether it is going to harm the society or not, whether it is going to help the society or not. Alright, if it is harming, then they will not allow. But if it is helping to get those, like, you know, recovery faster, probably, you know, they will give some kind of analytics and research data to the Glaxo saying that, okay, these are the competitors who are already there in the market. These are the kind of drugs which are already there in the market. This is the chemical composition. If you do X plus Y plus Z, you know, this is the best combination which will be coming up in the market, and you can win this particular market and, you know, get all the competitors out of this particular China market. Right? Now, when they have this particular research data, they will do the analytics. Analytics means like, you know, when you have the data points, you do the analysis of those data points. Now, the analysis of those data points is actually, it's the hardcore, you can see the mathematics. Do you understand mathematics and statistics? So this is the kind of like, you know, when you have the data points, they actually do the analysis in terms, if we go for solution number one, this is the pros and cons. If we go for solution number two, this is the pros and cons. If we go for solution three, these are the pros and cons, right? So once in the research and analytics sector, we have two very, very important points, which are like, you know, one is your decision support system, one is your decision making system. So once you like, you know, when you go for decision making system, then you are actually letting your customer know that, you know, you go for strategy X only, right? And decision support system, like, you know, you give three solutions or two solutions to the clients saying that these are the three solutions, you choose one of them, all right? Now it's up to you. Now the pros and cons of X is this, Y is this, C is this. So E-Value Serve actually, you know, they help the clients in decision support system, not in the decision making system, all right? So we propose this solution to them, they pick up the best from them. Now you can see that, you know, these are the points about E-Value Serve, you can probably, you know, read it. These are the kind of people whom we recruit from the market. Now you can see a different line of, for the different line of businesses, we recruit different kind of, like, you know, the people who are coming along with the professional qualifications. So you can see the MBAs are there, engineers are there from almost all these streams. We have chartered accountants, we have pharmacists, biotechnologists, journalists, law graduates, designers, architects, and for these industry verticals. Now, if you can see the industry verticals, that is financial services, you have life sciences and healthcare, professional services, and the corporates, where you have telecommunication, energy, and chemicals. Now, why for these industry verticals, do we require statistics, economics, like, you know, the people who will be actually doing the work on the research and analytics side of the financial services. Now, for this telecommunication, a BCom graduate or MBA in marketing would not be able to justify the job because we would require engineers in telecommunication. Probably, you know, they come up with the subject knowledge of that particular industry and then they apply that particular subject knowledge for the doing the research and analytics work. Okay, and then we have these four verticals, which is your intellectual property, your data analytics, market research, and knowledge technology. Knowledge technology is something like, you know, which you call it IT. To support, these are the, actually, you know, these are called the horizontals. So you have the verticals and then you have the horizontals which cut across all the verticals. So knowledge technology, which is an IT division, the technology is required everywhere. Okay, so this is how, like, you know, to cater to these industry vertical customers, we require these kind of people, and these are the horizontals which are actually, you know, helping these industry verticals and provide solution to the end customers. Okay, so this is about EVALS. Now, important, what are we here for today? So what exactly do we expect from the academia and the future managers? So you tell me, like, you know, what is our expectation? I being from the corporate sector, what do I expect from you? What qualities you should be having to enter into the corporate sector? Tell me. Let's make it so interactive. Yeah.
Innovative.
Okay.
Good communication.
Leadership is good planner and decision making.
Okay.
Team building qualities.
Competitive
with other clients or other
audiences. Okay, what else? Punctuality and ethics.
Punctuality and ethics.
ethics. Okay.
Leadership quality.
Okay. So lots of like you know answers which are coming in. Now you need to explain what is leadership. Who said leadership? Explain what is leadership. What do we expect from you as a leader? Let him answer.
सर जो मैनेजर है वो अपने साथ अपनी पूरी टीम को लेके चले, वो फ्रंट में रहे हर चीज को फेस करने के लिए, उसकी टीम उसको सपोर्ट करे पीछे से.
So how many of you
is a leader?
So how many of you do you agree with this explanation of leadership? Raise your hands. How many of you do you agree? देखो तुम्हारे साथ कोई भी अग्री नहीं करता. Now you tell me, like you know, leaders are there to create followers. Do you agree with this? What are they there for?
What
is the most important work of a leader? That a manager can do that. Nobody other than a leader can judge anything.
No, sir.
So what do you mean to say?
The leader will take the first initiative.
First initiative they will take. And rest will not take.
Yeah, the team members will cooperate.
They will just cooperate, but they will not take any initiative. It is the only leader.
That's why he's a leader.
Okay. Anybody else with some beautiful thoughts?
So they have to maintain relationship between higher officials and the employees.
Okay.
That main message from here and there.
To keep the team together.
There should be no communication gap between top level management and lower level management.
So leaders are there to do this work?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
So they create other leaders to create.
That's fantastic. This is what I was looking for. So what you are saying, like you know, do you understand the meaning of? Do you understand the difference between a manager and a leader? Is manager a leader or is leader a manager? सुनाई नहीं पड़ा मुझे. एक
बोलो.
एंड मैनेजर इज नॉट अ लीडर. ओके. नाउ व्हाट ही सेड इज लाइक यू नो अ लीडर एक्चुअली हिज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वर्क इज टू क्रिएट लीडर्स विद इन द टीम. दैट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एक्सपेक्टेशन फ्रॉम द कॉर्पोरेट सेक्टर्स टुडे. We just do not need leaders like you know who are actually bridging the gap between the management and the junior level staff. No, it's not that. We need leaders from the academia who can come and create leaders within the team. Everybody should be like you know working as a leader to create a team and you know earn a lot of dollars for the organization. So that is the only like you know why the corporates are running. Actually, they are not doing any kind of charity. They are there in the market to you know earn dollars. Do you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
And you are working with them to earn money again. So are we going to do any kind of charity? Are you going to join Eval Reserve? And what if we do not pay you anything, a single penny? Would you create some leaders in the organization?
No, sir.
Why? Why you will not do that? You want money to, you know, give some kind of output to the organization, correct?
Yes, sir.
So here, if you want money to give some kind of output to the organization, organizations also want some kind of things from you as well, so that we grow along with you. Okay? Now see, you like, you know, you are in the first semester, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you must be having lots of expectations from the institute. You might be having lots of dreams, like, you know, what will happen after 2 years, and there I will go, I will become a part of this organization, that organization, I will become a manager or a management trainee or a CEO or a VP. How many of you want to become a CEO after 2 years?
Nobody can.
Raise your hand.
Nobody can.
Raise your hand. One. CEO? Okay. So there are 4 or 5 people in this particular hall who want to become CEO after 2 years. Why it is not possible?
Sir, because we are told that we have to start from the sales initially.
What is sales thing?
Yeah, like initially you have to start
with. Sir, if we are going for any operations and FDA operations, used to ask for having experience in department or in partner specialization. That is not quite worthful that we should create most of CEO after 2 years.
If not CEO? How many vice presidents are here? Please, please raise your hand. The future vice presidents. Future vice president just after 2 years. Nobody. Now, what if the corporate wants you to become a vice president the moment you graduate from this college? Are you guys ready for that?
Yes, sir.
Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now you tell me what is the current GDP of India? So you being the CEO of the organization, your organization is making $100 million loss. Give me 2 best strategies to penetrate European market, because we are making a huge loss in the European market. Please come up with some strategies. Future vice presidents and the CEOs. We are making a huge loss in the European market, and it's a $500 million loss. So we are thinking of closing down the European market, our offices, and we just want to operate here in India. So give us some strategies, like, you know, how you can exactly save the European market so that, you know, we are able to sustain there. So please, future vice president and CEOs, raise your hands and give me 2 strategies to do that. You said that, you know, you guys are ready. You said you guys are ready to become VPs and CEOs. Give me these answers. It means we are not ready. Now, do you agree we are not ready? Agree? Okay, you will consult to EVALISUB, then EVALISUB will charge you actually. So EVALISUB will charge you. Now here, the question is, after 2 years, you are actually become a part of EVALISUB and you are given the task to save the organization from this particular task. Are we ready, guys?
No.
Are we ready? No, we are not ready. Okay. Why we are not ready? So you are aware that, you know, you do not have that much of knowledge, right? What corporate expects from you are not having that particular knowledge or the base ready. Agree? Now, who will teach you and who will guide you to reach to that particular level and meet the expectation of the corporates? Who will do that? Who will do that? Institute will do that. Only it's the institute's liability and the responsibility to do that. Okay. So now what corporate expects nowadays, where exactly you are coming from, whether it's Jaipuria or anywhere else, you should have some qualities inbuilt within you that should actually excite us to take you in the organization. And if you, like, you know, give this responsibility to only academia, only to Jaipuria management to nurture you, I think you are not doing it justice with yourself and with the college. Teacher is going to be one for this particular room, for example, right? But one of you will only top in the first semester. So the same teacher is actually teaching the same thing to all 100 people, but why only one is topping the class? Do you have this answer? So for that topper, teacher has done a wonderful job. And for those who have not been able to do a good job in the examination, teachers have not done a good job and teacher is bad. Correct? This is what happens. Like, you know, you must have, like, you know, graduated from somewhere and you did not score a good marks. Oh, my teacher was pathetic. But when you scored a good marks, oh, that was me, like, you know. So for any success we attribute to ourselves and for failures we give it to somebody else. Am I right? Alright, so let's be practical guys now, because you know, now you are in the management, and management is what? In simple terms, you get the job done by others. Correct? You manage the situations. So do you agree with the fact that, you know, the best managers are actually, they learn the management from home, not from the institutions. Do you agree with this? How many people do you manage on a daily basis? You manage your parents, you manage your friends, you manage your teachers, and you manage this particular society. It means you have the management capability which you have been learning since the day one, when you were born on this earth. Do you agree? Now what are you here for in Jaipuria today? To nurture those skills, to polish those skills, okay? To know what exactly is management, like, you know, yes, what you know, that is the home management, your friend's management, but here is the corporate management where exactly you are going to earn money. If you are managing your friends, you are not getting paid for that, am I right? If you are managing your parents, you are not getting paid for that, but if you are managing your customers, your internal stakeholders in the organizations, you are getting paid for that. If you are getting paid for that, then you need to have some qualities to deliver your task. Do I make sense?
Yes, yes.
Correct? Now see, like, you know, this is a very important slide which is very close to my heart, which I am just going to show it to you. The bare truth of life. Say this.
Completion of their task, something they target yesterday.
Do you agree?
Yes.
I don't. How are you measuring your performance? If you do not have the measurement of your performance, how will you see that, you know, I'm performing at this particular peak level? Only comparing with others.
Basically, performance is effective plus efficient use of the resources, and completing it in better time than others.
Okay, one way, yes.
That's how we measure it. He has done it in 5 minutes, I can do it in 4 minutes. That's okay. Also a performance.
You understand setting the benchmarks?
Yes, sir.
Right. So, let's say from Delhi to Agra, you travel this distance in 2 hours. Okay, for example. So, and the next time when you travel, due to, you know, certain due to probably heavy traffic or something, whatever the reason may be, you take about 2.5 hours to reach Agra. Then what was your benchmark to reach Agra from Delhi to
2 hours?
Now, to reach Agra in those situations where there is a less traffic or a normal traffic, you take 2 hours. Now you expect everybody else to reach Agra in 2 hours only. That becomes your benchmark, right? And then that becomes your expected performance. To reach Agra is 2 hours. If you reach there in 1.5 hours, you exceed the expectation of reaching to Agra. But if you take 2.5 hours, you are not exactly, you know, at the set level of performance, you are taking 2.5 hours to 3 hours. Right? So performance is what? If the performance matters where the benchmark has been set. The benchmark has been set. That's the expected level. Now, if you talk about the performance management in the corporate sector, so we have like, you know, the rating-based systems. Like, you know, you are given some percentage of marks or CGPA to measure your performance in the academics. How much did you score in physics or chemistry or management or finance or whatever, right? So similarly, in the corporate sector, the performance bars which are there, this is expected from you. If you're below this, you get this. If you achieve more than, then you exceed expectations and you achieve, you become guru. That is the outstanding performance. So outstanding performance, whatever at work in the corporate sectors, it does not matter to us whether you are coming from IIMs or you are coming from Jaipur or you are coming from EMBA, from where, I don't know. This is the most important expectation from the corporate sectors today. It's not the brand name which you are carrying, it's about what you are carrying on the table as an individual. Okay, so it is not only institution's responsibility to nurture you, but equally it is your equal responsibility to help them nurture you. Because they are the industry leaders, they are here, they understand the market, they are here to guide you, to mentor you. Like, you know, what exactly is required in the corporate sectors, and that's what they are here to teach you. Okay, now if you think that, you know, this 2 years course, just passing the papers is going to help you, is not exactly going to help you. This is not the only criteria. You secure good marks, that is very, very important, like, you know, that because that is an entry criteria. You get into the selection parameters of any of the organizations. Let's say 70% is the cutoff, where 10th, 12th for graduation or MBA, everywhere you should be like, you know, having 70% throughout. That becomes the weeding out criteria for the organization. Why? Because, you know, there are 8 lakhs engineers, they pass out every year in India. Are you guys aware?
Yes, sir.
Now, do we have the capacity to interview all those 8 lakhs people? We do not have, we cannot meet all those 8 lakhs people. Then what corporates do? They set the criteria of percentage of marks. Those becomes the weeding out criteria. Out of 8 lakhs, we are here to meet 800 best people who scored best marks in the organization, in the academia. Correct? Now from that perspective, you need to make sure that all of you score a very, very good marks to be able to register yourself for that particular organization which you bring for. Okay? So do not take this MBA degree non-seriously. Please do not take this non-seriously. This is a very serious affair. Otherwise, you will not be able to even go for a first level of discussion with the corporate sector. They will not allow you to sit for a test. Like, you know, I can see there are few people sitting in this particular room who are not very much serious. And I can, like, you know, pick and choose right now with my 14 years of experience. Okay, now this is what all the corporates are there who are experienced in, you know, recruiting people for those organizations. They know whom to choose, whom not to choose. Even if you have scored 90% marks, it doesn't mean that, you know, you are going to be the top performer of that organization. Something else is required actually, apart from the academic marks, something else is also required which you need to probably, you know, say. What are those? Let's talk about it. So do you agree with this? Now you understood the concept? Okay. So do not have this kind of fear that, you know, the IIM graduates like, you know, I'm Ahmedabad or I'm Lucknow or KG Somaiya of the world or Jamnal Al-Bajaz, they are the best. No. All of you are the best. If you have those qualities. Okay? So from today onwards, you should be motivated enough that in the corporate sector, only performance matters and nothing else. Okay? Now you see this. Some very important strategies. us, what are the pressing concerns? What we are not getting actually? So you can see the 40% organizations are saying we are competing for talent globally and in the emerging markets. So what is that talent? It's not only about like, you know, the graduates coming from the engineering colleges or MBA colleges having 80%, 85% marks. That is good. But there are certain traits which are the behavioral traits which are missing. Anybody coming up with a very, very negative attitude with 90% marks is not going to succeed in the organization. Why? Because we will not have that particular person, because if we have that person with a bigger attitude, he is actually making other four people to leave the organization. Do you agree? So here what matters? 41% organizations are actually, we are struggling a lot to get talent, which is a blended mix of your academics plus the behavioral traits which you bring on the table. Okay? Then you can see 38% selecting and developing leaders and succession planning. You were talking about the leaders, like, you know, the leaders are there to create leaders within the organization. It is not expected from the day one, but you become like, you know, you show some. And this is a hard core fact. The truth of the corporate sector. So do not ever think that, you know, you have spent 5 or 6 years and you are eligible for becoming a manager. No. With 1 year you can be a manager if you have those traits. Okay. Now the third is retaining employees at all the levels. That is the first biggest challenge what we are facing. Retention, you understand?
Yes.
So every organization would like to retain the top talent and let go of the bottom performers, non-performers. Do you agree? And fourth is the, we are finding it hard to find the right skill sets, or we call it as like, you know, hard to find skill sets, niche skill sets, or probably, you know, the criteria is probably which are actually required to become a sales guy, a quality which is actually required to become a hardcore true HR professional, a finance professional. So you come along with a lot of knowledge in finance, you come along with a lot of knowledge in HR, but is that only thing which is going to help? There are so many more parameters which are actually we are wanting in you, which probably those are missing nowadays, which you need to, like, you know, develop yourself with the help of your professors. You need some guidance from them. Be in touch with them always. It's just not about the books which you, like, you know, you read the Kotler book for marketing. Then you read some organizational behavior, you read some organizational development books. Those are the books to, you know, gain the concepts. What exactly are those? But, like, you know, what exactly happens on the ground? Get in touch with your professors and, like, you know, get in touch with your seniors who are there in the market. What exactly is happening on the ground? That is very important for you to know. Alright, now see, what exactly are those which we require, which we want from you when you come on board? Okay, there is a slide which is now coming. So there are a couple of things which I am showing it to you in one go. This present, the next slide is not coming as like, you know, 1 point. Then the second point appears, then the third point appears. I tell you the rationale behind that. See this. This is what we want. This is what corporate wants. You know, this particular list, why I have given it in one go? Because we want all this in you in one go. There is no time for you to develop something, you know, in a later stage. So this is what corporate expects today from all these future managers. I'm not talking about hard work. I'm not talking about any positive thinking. I'm not talking about any smart working over here. Right? I'm not talking about anything else like, you know, probably which you started telling me when we were talking about what it brings you to become a great leader. But here, things are a little different. So on the top you can see it's a strong social networking skill which we require today from the future managers. Social networking skills not on awkward, not on Facebook, like you know where you just do the some kind of those love quizzes or making some friends, doing unnecessarily bekar wala stuff, not that. Here, what we want is one person is coming from Jaipur and is actually taking 10 good people from their network to join EvaluServe or to join Google or to join Microsoft. Okay? It's the network which you are actually carrying across the globe. It's not only your batchmates who are connected with you, but it's about your friends, your networks who are there in European region, who are there in APAC, who are there in the US, who are there in Australia. It's the global network what we want from you, that you bring along with the social networking skills. Very, very important today. Reason being, the same. There is a war for talent. It's a war for talent. Now do you know, a very interesting fact is from the NASSCOM. NASSCOM says, out of 10 lakhs people who are actually graduating from the engineering and MBA colleges in India every year, only 15% are employable. This is the NASSCOM data. Only 15% are employable, it means out of 10 lakhs, how many we can take? 1.5 lakhs only. Correct? What about the 85% people who are not employable? And who are not employable, what does it mean who are not employable? People who are not good communicators. People who do not bring good social networking capabilities. These are the factors which are missing in those 85% people, that's why they are unemployable. Though they carry good 85 or 95% marks as well. Okay? Business acumen, when we say. Let's say if I come to Jaipur this year to hire MBA in finance, MBA marketing and MBA HR folks. Now, what do I mean by this business acumen? In fact, I can probably, if I'm interviewing you, I can say, okay, tell me, are you available on LinkedIn? Now, my question to all this group is, how many of you are available on LinkedIn? But there are few who are not available on LinkedIn. Now, if I ask you, what is the maximum number of connections do you have in your LinkedIn network? Tell me, anybody with more than 500? Raise your hand. Now, this is what is corporate is expecting. If you do not have even more than 500 connections, and those connections are not something like, those are actually the professional connections I'm talking about. Are you connected with your seniors? You're not. Start connecting with your seniors because they are already an industry stalwarts now. They're working somewhere. They will help you get somewhere in a good position. Right? So start increasing your LinkedIn network. And your Facebook network, you can do that, but please do not involve yourself in Orkut-like activities. Do you know how many of you are on Orkut? Do you know Orkut?
Yes, sir.
But you are not there on Orkut? Good, it's going to close down. Alright? So that is not the social networking which I am talking about. ठीक है, फोटो डालना और वो सब नहीं, उस नेटवर्किंग की बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ on Facebook. I am talking about the professional relationship, the professional networking. Now business acumen. You are coming from the HR, some of you are from finance, some are you from your marketing. So when we talk to you during the interview discussion, you only talk about what you have read, bookish knowledge. But do you have the business acumen, how the corporate sectors are actually, what exactly is the HR department in the corporate sector? What exactly is the sales function doing in the corporate sector? How exactly the finance, the CFOs are to ensure that the organization is earning good revenue. You have that knowledge. Have those knowledges, because you know, how will you get to know about that? Through your social network, through your seniors, through your professors. Ask them how corporate works. Do a lot of case studies, like, you know, pick it up from Google. It's not only about, like, you know, what teachers are going to teach you, but it's about, like, you know, how you are teaching yourself with your self-effort. Go to Google, take out some good case studies, and get to know what exactly happens on the ground. So the corporate world is entirely different from the books. Books are giving you the base. वो कहते हैं ना, जब घर बनाते हैं तो नींव बनता है पहले. तो एकेडमिया क्या है? That's a नींव. अगर ये खराब हो गई तो बिल्डिंग गिर जाएगी बाद. So this is your base where you are sitting right now. इसको स्ट्रॉन्ग करके रखने का है, इसके ऊपर बिल्डिंग बने. So business acumen में it's not only about the subject knowledge, but how that applies in the corporate sectors that you need to know. You know about recruitment and selection. चार लाइन की डेफिनेशन पढ़ लिया, एग्जाम में लिख दिया. रिक्रूटमेंट एंड सिलेक्शन, यू नो, पीपल गो एंड अप्लाई फॉर अ जॉब एंड यू नो दे गेट द शॉर्ट लिस्टिंग एंड समबडी फ्रॉम एचआर कॉल्स अप, इंटरव्यू हैपेंस एंड वी गेट द ऑफर लेटर. फोर और फाइव प्रोसेसेस, बट विद इन दोस फोर एंड फाइव प्रोसेसेस व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज हैपनिंग, दैट्स अ होल लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स व्हिच आर हैपनिंग. द सैलरी व्हिच यू आर गेटिंग और यू आर बीइंग ऑफर्ड फ्रॉम द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, हाउ डू वी डिसाइड हाउ मच सैलरी शुड बी पे. There is a compensation and benefits department within the organization who do the compensation survey in the market. How do they do that? So that is the kind of business acumen that corporate wants today, that, you know, every future manager should be knowing those stuff. Are you guys with me?
Yes, sir.
Highly influential. This is the third expectation from us. Now, we do not want anybody from the academia, the future managers, who are coming and sitting at a bench, at a desk, and working in silos. Some work is given, and you just perform that particular task the way your manager wants you to perform. That is not the only way. You should be influential enough to come up with your own ideas. Somebody said innovation is required, right? That innovation is obviously required. Initially, unless you know about the job, you would not be able to innovate. You would not be able to, you know, come up with some good strategy unless you diagnose the present system. Correct? So once you diagnose the present system, you get to know to reach Agra from Delhi, what can be the hurdles? What are the hurdles? So when you drive down, then you get to know the hurdles. And then you diagnose and come up with some new innovative ideas. Now, the corporate expectation is, we do not want to give you 2 or 3 years to, you know, reach to that level. You have spent 6 months in the organization, you should be smart enough to innovate, start innovating now. This is the process right now. Okay, tell me, what other good ways do you think that, you know, that can be better? Where we can achieve the same kind of result fast? This is what we expect from the future managers. It's not only about the spoon feeding. It's not. So gone are the days now. We need the smart managers today who come on board after 1 year, they take the charge, and the leaders of the organization, they start investing their time in the new budding managers. And then the entire organization, like, you know, grow up to the leader altogether. Then, the ability to create a vision. Every organization has a vision. You also have a vision for your career, what you want to become, right? So, ability to create a vision for the organization and for yourself is what we require from the future managers. That, you know, challenge our vision. Come and challenge. I am saying that, you know, eValuServe wants to become, let's say, $5 billion organization by 2015. Now, you should have the ability to create your vision and challenge my vision, saying that, boss, why $5 billion? Let's go for $7 billion. This should be the vision, and these are the strategies. This is what we want from the future managers. Okay? So you should know how to create your vision so that you can write vision for the organization where you go and work. Your quick decision making capabilities, this is actually क्योंकि तुम्हारी तो आदत है कि वो वर्ड फाइल को सेव करना है और एक्सेल को सेव करना है बट यू वुड नॉट बी एबल टू डू दैट सो हियर वी वांट दैट यू नो व्हाट एवर द सिचुएशंस आर देयर इन द कॉर्पोरेट यू शुड बी एबल टू अडैप्ट दैट पर्टिकुलर चेंज सो दिस इज द अडैप्टेबिलिटी टू द चेंज मैनेजमेंट विद इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अंडरस्टूड ओके एंड देन वी टॉक अबाउट द कल्चरल डाइवर्सिटी सॉल्यूशन ओरिएंटेशन दिस इज very very important today every day being the, like you know you being the manager the future managers of the organization if you are not able to provide solution to your not only to your customers but to your team members as well what if you become a manager one of few of you were saying that you know I want to become a CEO vice president or associate vice president whatever managers now if you are a manager you will have a team working under you they come up with some kind of problem issues as a manager do you have the capability to come back to them with the solution if you are not aware of the solution how would you guide your team members to work in that particular manner and to reach at that particular level of performance which is expected from you and your team members would you be able to do that so solution orientation is something which is required from the day one in the corporate sectors the problem is given to you it's all about organization is what it's all about problem solving on a daily basis you will just be solving the issues and nothing else issues are with the customers issues are with the clients issues are with these internal stakeholders everywhere the issues are there nowhere it is a smooth function nowhere even in the distribution channel some medicines are not reaching Assam region now there is an issue so how do you ensure that you know yes there has to be some solution that you know those medicines should reach Assam region where the people should be able to pick up those medicines and get well that is how the solution orientation and last but not the least is the loyalty so loyalty in this generation is actually missing nowadays people are coming joining the organization other organizations are coming and throwing 20,000 rupees more and you decide to leave your first organization and join another organization now think from that perspective now that if I see in your resume in your CV that in the last 2 years you have changed 4 jobs for example what would I think change management you are perfect right from one organization where you spent just 6 months and then you change another organization then again you change you went to the new organization did some kind of change management expectation management oh you are perfect for 2 years 4 organization 4 bosses my god that's too good it's not why you were leaving because you were not able to manage that particular change within the organization in 6 months you realize my boss is very tough both the sales target is very tough what should I do mere ko to incentive bhi nahi milega mere ko ye bhi nahi milega pata nahi mere appraisal ka kya hoga I should leave and join another organization and you join another organization now do you think in the another organization if they have paid you 20,000 more they will not give you that much of challenging task they will so tell me a name of the company probably I would also like to become a part of that organization which actually only pays you the salary and they do not give you any work and targets name any organization is there any there is no so targets are going to be there and we need to achieve those targets so loyalty would mean if an organization is actually hiring you is investing a lot of money in you and your training you need to be loyal enough to be with that organization prove yourself this is what I have learned and this is what I bring on the table this is much the number of this is what the dollars which I am earning for the organization now I have done this much of bit I am growing in the organization I should be here only all right and then you spend your considerable number of years, at least 3 years you should be able to spend in one organization. This is my personal suggestion to all the future managers. The job hoppers are not appreciated anywhere. Job hoppers means changing the jobs frequently. Okay? So stability of 3 years is something what takes you to the next level, which is very, very important. So show your loyalty, and just think one, which is very, very important, is if the organization is investing a lot of money in you, they are actually showing trust. If I come over here and hire you, actually I am showing some kind of trust that I spend 1 lakh rupees in you and you will give me some ROI. Correct? And if you are not giving me that particular ROI and you are jumping organization from organizations, any other good organization will think that, you know, this guy is not a loyal person. I spend, but he does not give me anything in return. So show this loyalty. This is what we expect as a corporate sector. So here, you know, the list which I have given, these are the vital expectations from the corporates. I'm representing not only Evalisim, but I'm representing the corporate as a whole. I work in 5 organizations in my 14 years of career. Okay. I have not written anything about hard work or persuasiveness and blah blah blah, those 5-6 systems. These are very, very different, you will not find in the books. Okay? Why? Because I have not written, those are implied. You should be a smart worker, yes indeed you should be. So those you are coming along with, but these are the things which you do not carry when you go to your employers as a future manager. So apart from those, these steps are required from the corporate sector. Alright? Okay. Any question? The ground reality or not?
Yes, sir.
So these are the ground realities. Focus on your studies. Where you are today, this is the best place. Because you are here today. Okay? That was your conscious decision to do an MBA program?
Yes, sir.
Respect that decision of yours. That was your conscious decision to come to Jaipuria? Respect your decision. Do well, achieve good marks, more than 80%, because you know that is the winning out criteria in the good organizations where you dream to be in future. If you do not score good marks, you will not be eligible to appear for even an aptitude test. Make sure that you know you are there, and then prepare yourself on these grounds. Those other stuffs, hard working, when you go to the employer, you talk about, I need some challenging environment. What do you mean by challenging environment? I need some challenging jobs. What do you mean by challenging jobs? Let's say if you are getting interviewed today, if I ask you, what do you expect from Evalisir? Sir, I need challenging job. Explain me what is challenging. So, speak that thing only, say those things only which you really understand what are those. Okay, otherwise, please do not talk about those. When you are convinced, prepare yourself on these lines. Now, then you see the difference within you. You are then ready for the corporate next move if you are equipped with all these stuffs. So, be on LinkedIn. Corporates, get in touch with them, get in touch with the, how many of you are from the HR background? None of you. Okay, so how many of you aspire to be the HR professional? Okay, and finance? And marketing? Many? Okay. Alright. Okay, any question for me, guys?